In an ideal world, we will have separate facilities or processing lines for each allergen, but unfortunately, this is not realistic. That is why an allergen control such as cleaning is vital. The objective of allergen cleaning is to remove product soils from shared equipment and tools to prevent cross-contamination. Remember, allergen cleaning is not always the same as cleaning for hygienic purposes. So what do you need to consider when designing an allergen cleaning regime? Start by looking at the nature of the product soil, meaning the residue left on equipment after you've made your product. Ask yourself, is it easy or difficult to remove? Does processing change the product in such a way that it becomes more difficult to remove? Food soils can be complex films consisting of multiple food components, or they can be simple, easy to clean powder residues, or anything in between. Remember, allergens are proteins, and proteins, when they have, for example, been heat denatured, can become more difficult to remove. The type of processing, the nature, and the complexity of the food soil, and the type of equipment and tools used will determine what type of cleaning method is appropriate. Next, complete a comprehensive risk assessment or review. You need to determine what needs to be cleaned and when it needs to be cleaned. To identify what needs to be cleaned, find all the places where cross-contact can occur across the manufacturing process and environment. Remember to consider the design and construction of equipment. For example, are there any areas where soils are likely to stay behind? For example, dead spots. To identify when to clean, review your allergen cleaning production schedule. Now, set a cleaning goal and build your regime to achieve it. How clean do you want your equipment to be after cleaning? Do you want it to remove all detectable allergen residues, or do you want equipment to be visually clean? Ask the following questions. What type of detergent can and should I use? Should we use hot water, or will cold water suffice? How much time will it take to complete the cleaning regime? Do we need to clean in or out of place? Must equipment be dismantled? There are three valuable tools when building an allergen cleaning regime. One, mechanical energy, for example, scrubbing, product or water turbulence, and high pressure water jets. Two, thermal energy, for example, warm water or hot CIP washers. And three, chemical energy, the action of cleaning chemicals or detergents on the food soil. The extent to which each tool is used will depend on the cleaning method and what is practical. For example, where it's not possible to use alkaline detergents, a lot of scrubbing may be needed. Wet cleaning methods are ideal to remove allergens because all three cleaning energies can be harnessed and water can be used to flush away residues. Four interrelated factors affect the efficacy of a wet cleaning regime. One, the detergent used and the concentration at which you use it. Two, the cleaning time, for example, total cleaning time, detergent contact time, or the CIP cycle time. The cleaning temperature, for example, the temperature of water used for manual cleaning, or the temperature of caustic and acid washes in the case of CIP. And fourthly, the amount of mechanical energy applied. All of these factors must be considered and validated during a cleaning validation study. When it is not possible to use water because it can affect the quality, safety, or stability of your product, dry cleaning must be used. Dry cleaning, while being a challenge, is not impossible. It relies almost entirely on using mechanical energy to remove food soils. Examples are vacuuming, brushing, scraping, wiping, and material or product flushes. Once a cleaning regime has been designed, it must be validated to prove that it satisfies the cleaning goal. Once it has been validated, it must be documented in detailed, easy to understand SOPs and implemented. Then you will start your journey of continuous verification to ensure the regime remains effective. To recap, we've learned that 1. Allergen cleaning is an important part of allergen control. 2. An allergen cleaning regime must be able to remove allergen residues from shared equipment and utensils. And 3. It must be validated and verified. In episode 4, I will share information on allergen cleaning validation and verification.